Ain't nothing out here but me, the road and the radio. Looking for an exit and a song that I might know. Counting down the memories, adding up the miles. Searching for a feeling I ain't felt in a while. Clarity and inspiration. Happiness is a destination that's hard to find. It may take some time. In my mind there's something more, and I'll open up a brand new door and find the strength to close the ones I left behind. And I'll get there leaning on some friends I know. The road and the radio.
Well, hello and welcome to another episode of The Road and the Radio. I'm your host, Justin Rafton, on this, the April 1st, April Fool's Day, as they call it. And I hope none of you have been pranked too hard today. And no, I got no pranks here on The Road and the Radio. But I do want to stick with that kind of theme and play some songs that will make you laugh here on April 1st. And actually, even last week, March the 27th, I did not know this. Actually, it's an official holiday. It's called the Quirky Country Music Song Title Day. And while the origins of this quirky little holiday are unknown, that day celebrates country music in all its glory. And let's be honest, whether you're a country music fan or not, country music doesn't pull any punches when it comes to its lyrics or its song titles. So whether it's going to be song lyrics that make us laugh, or some pretty quirky and bizarre titles that might have us scratching our heads, we're going to play some songs that are pretty big, and some songs you probably never heard of this week on The Road and the Radio, but hopefully they'll all put a smile on your face. We're going to kick things off with a song I know a lot of you have probably heard before, but I'm going to give you some of the backstory. It's a song called I'm Gonna Miss Her by Brad Paisley, and it all came back to when he was a student at Belmont University in Nashville, Tennessee in the early 90s, and was asked to participate in a student concert. Having primarily sung ballads at that point in his career, he decided to take a novelty song to his repertoire. And Frank Rogers, a fellow student who would eventually become Paisley's record producer, agreed, suggesting that they should write something that will make everyone laugh, and they came up with I'm Gonna Miss Her, a moderate up-tempo collaboration centralizing it on main character whose lover has threatened to leave him if he goes fishing instead of staying home. And he does choose fishing, which is quite the funny twist in the song. And he wanted to release it for his first album, but there was kind of worries that the song was more meant for more established artists, and then once he, you know, left it and other artists started to pick up the lyrics, they loved it. Like Garth Brooks, George Strait, Alan Jackson all really showed interest in recording the song. But Paisley kept it to himself and released it off his second album, Part 2, in 2002, which became a number one hit for 2 weeks, and one of his biggest still to date. So here it is, some Brad Paisley to make you laugh on this Tuesday afternoon, with I'm Gonna Miss Her on The Road and the Radio.
Well, I love her, but I love to fish. I spend all day out on this lake, and hell is all I catch. But today she met me at the door, said I would have to choose. If I hit that fishing hole today, she'd be packing all her things and she'd be gone by noon. Well, I gonna miss her when I get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore and I'm sitting in the sun. I'm sure it'll hit me when I walk through that door tonight. Yeah, I'm gonna miss her. Oh, looky there, I've got a bite. All right. If I hurry, I could beg her to stay. That water's right and the weather's perfect. No telling what I might catch today. So I'm gonna miss her when I get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore and I'm sitting in the sun. I'm sure it'll hit me when I walk through that door tonight. Yeah, I'm gonna miss her. Oh, looky there, another bite. Yeah, looky there, I've got a bite.
Beside me talking on his cell phone, he started yelling at me like I did something wrong. He flipped me the bird and then he was gone. Some beach somewhere, there's a big umbrella casting shade over an empty chair. Palm trees are growing and warm breezes blowing. I picture myself right there on some beach somewhere. I circled the parking lot trying to find a spot just big enough I could park my old truck. A man with a big cigar was getting into his car. I stopped and I waited for him to back up. But from out of nowhere, a Mercedes-Benz came cruising up and whipped right in. Some beach somewhere, there's nowhere to go and you got all day. Margaritas and hot senoritas smiling with long dark hair on some beach somewhere. Well, I sat in that waiting room, it seemed like all afternoon. The nurse finally said, "Doc's ready for you. You're not gonna feel a thing. We'll give you some Novocaine. That tooth will be fine in a minute or two." Then he stuck that needle down deep in my gum and he started drilling before I was numb. Some beach somewhere, there's a beautiful sunset burning up the atmosphere. There's music and dancing and lovers romancing the salt evening air on some beach somewhere. On some beach somewhere.
That was some Blake Shelton. A different sound he had back then. That was 2004 Blake Shelton with some great wordplay. Some funny lyrics in that song. Man does not want to go to the dentist or deal with any of the hectic things that life throws at him, but just wants to be on some beach somewhere. Great little song from him. Well, a great quirky little title in this next song, and I think a lot of guys might agree with it, especially once you get a little bit older. Here's some J.T. Hodges with his song, never released off his debut album, but still quite funny and a great part of his live set, with Rather Be Wrong Than Lonely on the road and the radio.
Fire's getting